Okay, so in the figure above, lines L and M are parallel, and lines S and T are parallel. And so we know that the measure of angle 1 is 35 degrees. We want to know what's the measure of angle 2. And just based on the answer choices, I think you could probably, you know, just... I wouldn't even do any work on this one. But again, let's talk about the some terminology just to be thorough. So angle 1, if I angle... Okay. If I label this as angle 3, since we've already got angle 2 over here, and if I label this one as angle 4, all of these angles have the exact same measure, okay? So angle 4 is also going to have a measure of 35 degrees. And since angle 2 and angle 4 lie along a line, we know that their measures have to add up to 180 degrees. So the measure of angle 2 plus the measure of angle 4, that has to equal 180 degrees. Well, again, we just said that the measure of angle 4 is 35 degrees. So we can subtract 35 degrees from each side and get that the measure of angle 2 would have to be 145 degrees. So it would be answer choice D. And again, you know, it's clear from the picture, right, from the diagram, the measure of angle 2, it's definitely larger than 90 degrees. And the only one of those four choices that is larger than 90 degrees, again, is answer choice D. So that's what I was saying at the beginning. If I saw this on the test, I'd be like, boom, answer choice D, and I would be off to the next one.